this explainer video about twin flames. I know, you're a twin and you feel stuck. The connection won't move forward and you can't leave it behind. Sometimes you wish you could just turn back time and never meet this person. I get it. You don't understand the dynamic, and again, you're unable to step out of the connection, but you're also unable to really step into it. It's like a holding pattern. This video does not recommend that you stay or leave. It only seeks to educate you on the facts, so you can make an informed decision about what you want in your life. Twin flame connections are energy based. Energy is like a storm, it just is. Energy can become other things, but at the same time, it's all still energy. Just like a storm can have clouds, rain, thunder, hail, and be followed by a rainbow, etc. But it all still comes from the original storm. A storm does what a storm does. It is not intentionally trying to hurt anyone. It is just being what it is, doing what it does. Storms and twin flame connections are similar in that way. Twin flame energy creates friction and the need for healing and growth. Not intentionally to hurt anyone. It is just what happens. The energy just continues to be energy, finding and exposing weaknesses or wounds, because that's what twin flame energy does. You then make of it what you will, good or bad, according to your own perception. Like with a storm, you can choose to go and stand in the middle of it, with or without protective clothing. You can shelter from it. You can fear it. You can embrace it. You can be excited by it. You can become stronger from experiencing it. You can be traumatized by it. You can learn from it, or you can run from it. What you can't do is change what it is. It is the same with twin flames or twin souls. They are the same oversoul energy. The energy just continues to swirl. And the twins push each other's buttons. That is what the energy does. These connections are powerful healing opportunities. How you deal with all this is your choice. That is the only control you actually have in these connections. You can decide to face your own fears, insecurities, and issues and learn, grow, and heal. Or you can spend your time trying to change the other twin, which you will eventually realize is pointless. These connections are about each person getting on with their own healing. People in twin flame connections usually see what those around them do not see. They understand that their deepest and innermost wounds and issues are triggered by their twin. Issues they are most likely able to hide from the rest of the world. Twins intrinsically trigger these deep wounds. Twins know they need the healing. However, the wounds are so deep that the fear can be insurmountable for them. Surface wounds and issues, which are what we generally face in our day-to-day lives. Beyond that are deeper issues. These issues generally only surface within connections with people we are close to, family, close friends. Then there are core issues or core wounds. These are like big, painful chasms deep inside our being. These are the major wounds from which the smaller wounds spring. These core wounds can be likened to a volcano, and the streams of lava are the smaller issues that come from within the core wound or volcano. In twin flames, core wounds surface. Am I good enough? What if it doesn't work out? Each twin knows they can't hide their wounds from their twin like they can with other people. That makes taking a chance on these connections really scary. Many twins will never take the steps to overcome these fears and begin a real relationship grounded in physical reality. While it is helpful for your growth and development to be triggered and heal, there is another thing that you will have considered as well. You may have already been going through this for years and years. This is what happens for some twins. These connections feel like home and are extremely difficult to even think about letting go of. For those long-term twins, life is very difficult. You will, of course, have already asked yourself, is it time to move on? It's a painful thought, I know. If, during this video, you find yourself relaxed enough, you may ask yourself that question again. As time goes on, you spend your days and nights wishing to be with someone who is not really in your life. It is a painful way to live. If you have already been in a twin flame connection for many years, you've done a lot of healing for sure. But has there been any real joy in your life? You know, after all this healing, you can choose to allow some ease and joy into your life. You can choose a connection that is less intense. And you can love this much again, even more. And you can have someone happily return that love to you. You just have to decide that is what you really want. Once you decide to really allow love into your life, the energies will move and you will be surprised what happens. The only person who can decide your next steps is you. I do not recommend one course of action or the other. This video only brings you healing energy and strength to make that decision. And it is okay to reconsider it again later. The music in this video contains solfeggio miracle tone, 528 Hz, for self-love and healing deep wounds, as well as 396 Hz. 396 Hz is known for releasing guilt, grief, and fear. However, the reason I included it in this video is because it relates to the root chakra, which is grounding. In my time counseling twin flame partners, I see again and again that the need and desire for your twin flame heightens when you or they are in fear or doubt. This is when your energies tend to reach out to each other for strength. For me personally, I felt this like my life force being drained. At times it was so extreme, I felt like I had to crawl because I couldn't even stand or walk. As I encourage my clients to walk through their own fears, be brave, and start taking steps in the direction they want their own lives to go in, there is a shift within them. Shift brings more courage, self-confidence, faith, and the belief that they can achieve their own goals. For twin flames, there seems to be an automatic, unconscious knowing that one twin has what the other needs in that moment, and their void seeks to be filled from their twin. As lovely and connected as that sounds, it can be quite devastating for the other twin. What needs to happen is that each twin needs to have the courage to go forward and achieve their own goals and allow those latent parts of themselves to grow and develop, not take the required energy from their twin. Then you achieve the healing and balance that is required for these connections to move forward. If you would like some support, you can reach me at sue@yourtwinflame.com. Please continue to listen and absorb the healing frequencies embedded in this video. Like, subscribe, comment, but most of all, enjoy.